One major challenge of mental health has always been funding. Despite increase in budgetary allocation, players also want to see commitment of government in establishing levy to make the law effective.
Shortages of food, drugs, consumables, debt accumulation and delay in funding for mental health care and activities has been the norm for years, affecting the quality of mental health care in the country. Even more, donor support for mental health also ended in 2018, compounding the challenges of psychiatric hospitals and the authority. This is, however, expected to change. The 2020 budget is allocating 15 million Ghana cedis for the three mental health institutions and the mental health authority, and stakeholders are enthused.
2020, the ministry's own funding to the mental authority is going to be drastically increased, and that is certainly a very good news for us. So thanks to the government, thanks to the Ministry of Health, thanks to the Ministry of Finance. So that is good. But I must say that is not adequate to cater for all our needs.
I am happy about what has been allocated for this year, because I must say that since I took over in 2016, I haven't seen any figures like this. Okay. So my prayer is that this allocation will be realized. And I must say that if it does, then we would see a lot of improvement in terms of the quality of care we give to our clients.
It's a giant step that government has taken. I think in the history of mental health in Ghana, this is the first time that we've had so much being committed to mental health for a year or for a period. And we are hoping that this money actually, as has been mentioned, will be released, and not that we're hearing the figures, but later on they will not really be finding their ways into these hospitals.
Chief Executive Officer of the Mental Health Authority, Dr. Kwesi Osei, says mental health needs extra funding and urged the Finance Ministry to, as a matter of urgency, establish the mental health levy.
All that we are doing is to advocate to get it done. Parliament has done its part in mentioning that we need a levy. And that has been mentioned in the mental health law, the parent law, and in the air law, which has been passed. And we are grateful to Parliament again for having passed that. So it makes mention of the need to establish a levy. Having said so, it's now left for the Minister of Finance to now establish it. And that is where now we are putting all the efforts to make sure that it's established.
Medical Director of the Pantan Hospital, Dr. Frank Bannin, proposes the incorporation of mental health into the NHIS.
National Health Insurance Scheme being a social intervention that is targeted towards the most vulnerable and the poorest, government could also consider bringing mental health services under the National Health Insurance Scheme.
On his part, Executive Director of the Mental Health Society of Ghana, Humphrey Kofi, said monies allocated to mental health are usually for feeding alone, and urged government to commit more resources into community work.
One of the key things we want to see this year is that government commits to ensure that there is a mental health levy. That levy would generate the income or the funding that will help us scale up community mental health. Because if we have to integrate people, treat people within the community and get them more integrated into the community, then we need to be able to provide the services within the community and let them remain in the community rather than having to get them to travel to any of the facilities back and forth. And that one, traveling back and forth, perpetuates stigma.
Expectations for quality mental health care and activities are high for stakeholders as they plan on ambitious programs for 2020. For them, the buck stops with government to redeem its financial obligations. AC Benewa Otu, TV3, Accra.